Hello and welcome to this video about understanding your vitamin blood tests. This is part of a wider series of videos where we look at all your organ systems piece by piece in other blood tests. If you want to find out about other things, check out the playlist. As always, if you've had a blood test and your results are all over the place, go see your doctor. Otherwise, stay tuned and we're going to start talking about vitamins. So let's start with the B vitamins, that's folate and B12. Folate, or folic acid if you give it its man-made form, is really important for good red blood cell production. If you don't have it, you might become deficient, which might lead to anemia. Now, folate is not stored in your body really, you get most of it through food, and you've constantly got to have it, and you can get it really easily through loads of different types of vegetables, especially the ones that you never liked eating at school, like broccoli and spinach. You can also get it in its man-made form as folic acid if you're having trouble getting it, and it's especially important if you're thinking about becoming pregnant or you are pregnant, make sure your folic acid levels are at a very good level because it helps with the development of the fetus. Moving on to B12. B12 is a really important vitamin, again, for red blood cell production, but also for things like DNA synthesis, so you kind of want to make sure you've got some. If you don't have B12, again, it can lead to anemia, and it can lead to all manner of unpleasant things like tingling in your fingers, so you want to make sure you've got a nice level. Now, if you eat meat, it's pretty easy to get your B12, because it's readily found in all kinds of meats. If you're a vegetarian, but you still eat cheeses and eggs, then no problem. There's loads of B12 in that. But if you're a vegan, things aren't so easy because B12 isn't really found in fruits, vegetables, and plants. It's not a problem if you are aware that B12 deficiency will be an issue because it's easy to get nowadays through things like fortified cereals, Marmite, and even over-the-counter B12 sprays and things like that. But you've got to make sure you're getting your B12. However, there are conditions like pernicious anemia where your body just is unable to absorb B12. And that can lead to low B12 regardless of how much you have in your diet. So if your B12 is low, there's probably going to be some verification tests which your doctor's going to want to do to see if that's because it's diet related or whether you have an underlying deficiency. And if you have an underlying deficiency, it's super easy to treat with B12 injections, but it's something to know about because if you don't treat it, it can lead to unpleasant things down the line. And that's why a B12 test is great to get. Now onto the vitamin D test. Vitamin D is super important. It's been in the news quite a lot with COVID because it goes down in COVID infections. It actually goes down in a lot of infections because it is a reverse inflammatory marker. But having good levels of vitamin D makes you feel happy, healthy. It's good for the immune system. It's good for concentration and it's good for overcoming fatigue and things like that. A lot of people, especially where I'm filming this in the UK, are not deficient, but have less vitamin D than they need because it's dark and it's miserable and you get a lot naturally from sunlight. You get some through food as well, but over the winter months, it's very easy to be low on vitamin D. Easily rectified, not just through some foods which are vitamin D rich, like some mushrooms, but also through simple over-the-counter supplements like vitamin D capsules or sprays. In fact, there's almost no harm in having a low-dose vitamin D supplement, especially over the winter months. It might help you feel a little bit better in yourself. As always, with vitamins and supplements and things like this, having too little is a problem, but also having too much is a problem as well. So you don't want to go overboard and give yourself a million units of vitamin D every day, because you'll probably give yourself vitamin D toxicity. Like anything, what we're trying to do is get you into a nice, healthy, normal range, and you can monitor that with an annual blood test very easily. So I hope that lets you understand what your vitamin blood test means. We've seen what happens when they go low, and they're very easy to boost back up with some supplements or through diet. It just takes a little bit of focus to know what's going on in your body so you can tailor your lifestyle to make sure you stay fit, healthy, and happy for longer and longer. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, it really, really helps. If you want to go into a bit more depth, just go to my website here, and you can also follow me on Instagram and ask any questions you like there. Thank you.